Happy Thursday, Upper Primary. Welcome on board this performing arts train as we continue our travels around the world. We will go back to Greece, back to Senegal, back to Italy slash France for our adventures. Please make sure you have plenty of space and you've got everything you need. So you might want your mask nearby for your drama. You might want a bar or a chair for ballet and potentially a drum or something that can act like a drum for music. When you've got all that, let's begin. All right, Upper Primary Drama Bods, welcome back. So I have put our slide on that we looked at last lesson on Tuesday as a little bit of a reminder before we move on with this. So this week we were thinking about head and neck movements and how much they will change when we wear a mask. So if you remembered, we got ourselves warm by thinking about the largest item in the room, smallest, the highest, the lowest, and we literally just looked at them with our head and our eyes. Yes, remember that? All right, to get us back into the swing of things, we're going to give that one more try just to remind ourselves, but do it slightly different. You're going to use your nose. Now, I do have to point out this fellow. I thought he was pointing to his nose. I'm now thinking he's picking it. Gross. Not recommending that, but I didn't really know at the time. So, what we are going to do is this. I'm going to ask you to look at those items again. Maybe you're in a different room today, so it'll be different ones to look at. Instead of just using your eyes, so if I'm looking at one of the lights over there, I might just do this. And I hardly move my head. Now, I want you to imagine there is like a laser beam coming from the tip of your nose, and you have to line it up perfectly with that item. So rather than just looking at that line with my eyes, I turn my full body so the nose makes a perfect line with the line that I can see that's off shot. All right? So we're going to start to think about how do we need to use our head to get that nose exactly in alignment. All right. We're going to try not to push out our necks and things. It's not like that. We're keeping it normal and relaxed. And just literally thinking about that laser light. All right, so let's give it a go. So, the largest item in your room, line your nose up. Now I have to move a little bit out of the way, you see, because the camera and the chair's in the way. So my nose needs to go a little bit more that way so that it can hit the largest item. Your right foot. So rather than just glancing down, I now need to make my nose line up with that foot. The item lowest to the ground. I've still got that beanbag, Mrs. Nelson. Oh no, I moved it. Oh, it's over there now. Make your nose line up. Good job. Your left thumb. So I'm really digging my chin, all of my chin stuff. I was like, oh, gross. Christmas was not kind. The smallest item in the room. Am I still going behind here? Oh, there's a pencil there. Line of the nose. Okay. The most colourful item in the room. Nice beach towel there, full of bright colours for me. The highest item in the room. Don't forget, we are lining up our nose. Not just using our eyes, so I've had to go for the air vent. Any window, line that nose up with the window. Great. Something that makes a noise. What did I? Oh, I had my drum, didn't I? There it is. Line up the nose. And last but not least, something that would roll if you pushed it. Oh, I can see a beach ball today. That would roll. So line up your nose. All right. I haven't gone insane. There is a reason for that. So, it is looking wild in masks, and you might want to get your mask out round about now. So, when we perform, we might not always think about our head and our neck movements. They just kind of come naturally to us, like me talking to you now. But, think about when you're acting in a mask. Your mask has constantly got the same facial expression. This big smile, in my case. So, if I need my character to look confused, I can't change that face. So I have to maybe look up to the sky and tap. Thinking. If It was like sad and disappointed. Perhaps I have to go. Sad looking down because I can't change the mouth. So we have to really think about where we're moving our head and our neck. It can also tell the audience what we're focusing on. So if I do notice something like the beach towel, I can turn my direction and my focus to there and tell the audience rather than just you moving my eyes, because no one's going to see my eyes move. I've just moved them when the mask is in the way. All right, let's warm up our heads and necks a little more by exploring their full range. And then we will try that one more time with the mask on and see how different it is, okay? So, can you move your head in as many different directions as possible? So think about all the different places, views where we could look, where's the furthest back it could go, up and down. Really warm that neck up, team. Next, tilt. How far can you tilt your head towards your shoulders? Maybe tilt slightly forward, tilt slightly back. Good. What about turning your head? So without moving your whole body, how far over your shoulder can you look and make that nice circular motion? Beautiful. All right. Tip your head. So tip it low. So if it's so heavy, tip it high. Oh my goodness, like it's on a lollipop stick and it can't stay upright. Moving that head, that different range. Which ways can you move your neck? So not about the head, think about the neck being a snake. What's happening to your head? Is your neck is exploring its range of movement. A little bit crazy. If someone's just tuned in, they'll be like, well, she's gone. She's officially lost it. And finally, what happens to your eyes? Where do they look at in the focus when we're doing these weird neck things? Very strange. All over the shop. Cool. We are going to go one more time with the mask. I'm going backwards. Put your mask on now for me, team. So don't forget, we can no longer see your eyes because they're too far back. And we are going to look at our list of things again with our mask on. Let's get this in the right position. There we go. All right. When you are ready, folks. So imagine you've got an audience watching you. You can't just make really slight movements. You've got to be really exaggerated. You want the audience to know what you're looking at. If you have siblings, maybe you can take turns. And you can look at something and say, guess what I'm looking at? And see if the person without the mask on can tell. All right, here we go. So the largest item in the room, look at it now with your mask on. Nice and big and dramatic. Your right foot. Really low down this time to properly show our audience. The item lowest to the ground. Thinking about all our body there. The left thumb. Very good. The smallest item in the room. All right. The most colourful item in the room. Good. The highest item in the room. Very good. Any window. Something that makes a noise. Good. And something that would roll if you pushed it. Very, very good, everyone. Okie dokie. So you can see it makes a huge, huge difference. I had to wait because reception arrived at the same time. It makes a huge difference when you've got your mask. And sometimes, like if you look down to your foot, it goes boo, and your eyes end up in the sort of cheek nose section, don't they? Well done, people. All right, so we have done all of that. What we are going to start to look at next week, we've run out of time for now, but You are going to create a little piece of drama in your masks, okay? So thinking about those head and those neck movements, you are going to enter the space, look around as if it's a room you've never been in before, notice the prop, react to a prop, so as I said above there, you will need a prop, and move the prop to a new location and then exit. So before Tuesday next week, you might want to have a little think about what prop you would like to use. I found a very cool microphone that I was prepared to use, but there's my Fitbit buzzing there. That could be a kind of cool prop. A prop, as a reminder, is anything you can hold in your hand. Examples: flower, pen, umbrella, book, magazine, microphone, anything like that, all right? Super well done, guys. We are really moving on well with all these different things we need to think about when wearing our masks. Next week, we'll have a look at this and we'll start to create our drama piece that we can perform before half term. But for now, let's move to music. All right, upper primary musicians. So I've left this on the board to remind us of what we looked at last lesson, on Tuesday. We were starting to think about combining rhythms, do you remember? And we watched that video of the three musicians from Juilliard. One was doing the stamp, one had the stamp, tap, stamp, tap, stamp, and then one had the stamp, hit, hit, hit. Stamp, hit, 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 and hitting their lap. All right, so we had a little try playing along with them, and I promised you today we would try and create some duets and potentially even trios. So let's do that then. So I am going to create a beat on this here drum. You can of course use a drum or a pan and a spoon, or continue to pat your legs, stamp your feet, clap your hands, whatever you want to do. You are going to make a different beat and we're going to attempt to do it at the same time, okay? So we'll start easy just to warm up and remind ourselves of what we were doing. I'll keep a steady beat first, right? I'll just go. So that counts one and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and, okay? We're doing counts of four. You need to find your own rhythm that isn't the same as this, that is in four beats. Yours might be one and away, two, three and away, four, one and. Yeah, while I'm going. That'll be you. For example, you're going to do it at the same time as me. You can make up whatever you like, all right? Have a second to think what your beat's going to be. It's going to repeat every four. Got something? Try to count it and make sure that you know where it lands. All right, let's give this a go. So, at the same time as me, ready? I'll start and you come in when you can. Okay, ready? Three, four. Okay, let's make it a little bit trickier this time. I will make a more complicated rhythm than the steady beat. You need a new rhythm, okay? Try at least. One, two. One, two, three. One, and a two. One, two, three. I can't just count one, two, three, four. I do that rhythm. Sorry, go again. Ready? Five, six, seven, and. It's so much to say it at the same time. Did you get it? I'm sure you did probably better than me. Alright, moving on. At the bottom, we have some energy describing words. Now, this is something that we've looked at already in drama, with how we would move our bodies, what energy scale would a character be on. So this can also apply to musical rhythms, musical beats, types of music. There is definitely calm, flowing music, and there is definitely fast, high-energy music, and they don't sound the same, do they? So, we are going to create another duet, another rhythm, but with one of those in mind. So, let's go for strong to begin with, okay? So we're both going to think of a strong rhythm, so the whole thing's going to be strong. So it might be quite loud. Kind of basic, but I think that's where I'm at right now. So one, two, three, and four, mine's going to be. You think of something else that's nice and strong. Got something? Of course, yeah. Right, let's try and get this in together. Ready? One, two, three, four. Amazing. Let's try this time different energies. So I'll be one energy, you be another energy. So I'll be calm, you pick another one. So your options are flowing, strong, fast, or high energy. I'm going to think of a calm one. Mine's kind of played quite lightly. So, have you got a flowing, a strong, a fast, or a high energy rhythm? So many numbers and things to think about. All right, ready? One, two, three, four. Going on as well. All right then, peeps. So our ultimate challenge to finish us off is, can we do a trio? How many people are in a trio? Three. So you think there's only me and you here. What are we going to do? Fear not. I have got a steady beat playing on this here compute. If I could find. It is there. So have a listen. That's our tempo. All right. So the TV musician number one is going to be one, two, three, four. You need something different, and I need something different, okay? Because I can't let you go first, because I can't hear what you're doing. I'll think of one, you think of something different. Say mine right in my head to make sure I've got it. Got something? Cool. All right, let's have a little try of this. Okay. One, two, three, four. One, two, three. Right, one last try we've got time for, but this time we are going to do it with our energy words, all right? So we've got Mr. Steady Beat here. Now let's remember them words. Flowing, calm, fast, strong, high energy. Think of an energy word. You can make them one yourself if you like. Think of an energy word that you're going to go with. I think I might go fast. Because I can't remember. I've just felt this below our primary as well. I've got rhythms all around my head. Hey, you got something? Pick an energy word, pick a rhythm. I feel like I've just done that one. Oh, think of something else, Mrs. Bates. Quickly, come on. With our warm-up, which is our plié at the bar. I hope you've got something nearby just to rest on. You can do it without, but it really hurts. So we have got our entire warm-up exercise finished now. In first position, second position, third position, and fourth position, we do a demi-plié, a rise, a full plié, and dégagé to the next position. This is our second. Third is in the gap. Fourth is straight ahead. Let's get straight on with it. It's nice and slow so you can copy me because I do want to leave some space for that dance at the end because I've chucked some really difficult moves at you recently, haven't I? Meanie Mrs. Bates, eh? Right. So at the bar, belly button through to the spine. Let's think about our posture. Thank you. get rid of your bars for me, team. It is time to move on to that rather challenging Allegro sequence, or on shame on. On shame on just means like a sequence, a combo. All right, so we did actually get to the end of this on Tuesday, but I'm aware it will need a little bit of practice, okay? So it starts in fifth position, which is when our heel goes to our big toe. We check both legs are turned out. Think of all those muscles twisting up around you. We've got sauté, sauté, which is the two jumps where we land in exactly the same spot. The glissade devant is when we do our glide to the side. We go straight into an assemblé de devant, which is when the legs assemble at the top. And our final new move on Tuesday was the changement, which means to change. So we just jump and change our legs in front, and then we have a moment to have blind panic before we go the other way. Let's try it a couple of times without the music, and then when I put the music on, we'll try one in slow-mo and one up to speed, okay? And it's up to you if you join in on that one. So two sautés. Jump, jump. Beautiful. Glissade to the side into our assemblé. So we do our glidey jump, and then we swish and land. And then we're going to change our feet. Whoop, and wait. Okay? Let's give that a go with our other leg in front now. So two sautés landing in fifth position. Jump, jump. We've got our beautiful glissade devant to the side where the front leg begins and ends in front. Whoop. We have our assemblé where we swish this leg out and then join the air. Poof! And then we change our feet and pause. That is our move. Let's try it a tiny bit quicker before we get that music on. Ready? 5, 6, 7, 8. Jump, jump, glissade, assemblé, change, wait, 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 jump, jump, glissade, assemblé, change, wait, wait, wait. All right, folks, let's try that with the music. Do whatever you can. Just keep gliding. Just check that your upper body posture is looking fabulous and no one will even know what it's supposed to look like. Don't even stress. So we're going to do it slow. Jump, jump, glissade, assemblé, changement, and wait, and beat. Ready? Here we go. And jump, glissade, assemblé, changement, and wait, sing it, just beat it. Other way, nice and slow. And jump, glissade, assemblé, and change. Okay, just do it again, so we'll just start to beat. Right, shall we give this a go fast? Jump, jump, glissade, assemblé, changement, wait. And jump, jump, glissade, assemblé, and changement. We then have the swishy slide into a hop. Push and hop. Push and hop. And then we did our gorgeous run to the back. La la la, the miraculous binoculars reappear. And we have this back leg in front. Now it's a tricky bit. Up, down, run, run, run. Up, down, run, run, run. But it's super zippy, isn't it? Do what you can with that, all right? We went. They walked for our eyes, weren't they? Up, down, run, run, run. Up, down, run, run, run. And the third one, the final run, is what gets us back in position. So really it's kind of two runs in a land. Up, down, run, run, in. Ready to go, okay? And then the bit I kept forgetting was to bring the miraculous binoculars down. And we did exactly what we've been doing in our Allegro jump, so I've not changed the cheeky PowerPoint. I like it when it's on the right page. Oh, I've lost the thing. There it is. Okay. We had exactly the same as our Allegro on Shema, which was the Glissade Assemblée, but I said you had to do some clever footwork, and you were just trying to work that out, weren't you, last time we saw each other. So the Glissade's up to the back, Glissade Assemblée, and then we go the other way, now the leg's at the back, so you might want to keep it at the back, and then do a little bit of trickery on that assembly, and bring it to the front. All right, friends, and that was where we got. Let's just try this knee bit again, a bit quicker. So we're round to the back. We go up, down, run, run, in. Up, down, run, run, in. Glissade assemblée, glissade assemblée. Do you know what? Even if it doesn't look good, at least we're getting the heart rate up and we're keeping fit, aren't we? Let's try that with the music and then you'll be pleased to know there's a nice easy bit straight after that. All right? I'm just thinking, are we on the wrong? Why is she over there and why over there? Have I missed something out? No? Maybe I have. Oh, because she travels a lot. I'm watching the woman on the thing. Never mind, we'll be over there. That's fine. Tuesday. Thanks for joining, everybody. Bye-bye.